what's up guys, Mark from Wandering Souls, back with a new update. I just decided to do a collection update. I actually wanted to put out my yearly video, but that will be the next video coming out. I just decided to put this in because there are some stuff in here that might be in that video as well. So I just want to show those stuff before I show the other video. What we're listening to Valencia from Behind the Lights, and of course the fucking dryer. But we have to do some washing, otherwise you don't have clean clothes, right? So collection update. I got a bunch of CDs to show you guys. This will be the last CD update this year. I'm waiting on CDs still, but that I will show in January probably. I'm kind of a mishmash here, some death metal, some black metal, melodic death, kind of mishmash stuff. There's even some heavy metal in here. So without further ado, the music is down a bit. Hopefully you can hear me good. Otherwise, let me know in the comment section. First thing is Armageddon with Svindelvip Asteste. Probably butchered that, but I'll leave correct link in the description so you can see the correct title. My Swedish isn't that good, so Swedish black metal, comeback album after 16 years of silence. This duo decided to put out an album. Who has released this? Probably can't read that, probably can't, but this is the back. The CD looks like this. I'm not gonna pull out the booklet because it's fucking thick and hard to get in and out. But fantastic, riffy, great, well played, crafted, black metal. You can't go wrong here. After 16 years of silence, it's great that such kind of band appears again with a new great album. I really enjoyed it. Fantastic stuff here. I was not super familiar with this band. I heard some stuff in the back and back in the day, like 15 years ago, 16 years ago, I heard from this band, and I heard something of the first couple of albums, but I never had an album or something. So when this finally pumped up after 16 years of silence to the previous album, I thought, well, I heard of this band, but I haven't have any material. So let's pull the trigger and buy their newest album. Great stuff. Fantastic black metal from Sweden, Armageddon. Great band to check out. Next up, an album that will be in a lot of people's year lists because it's really, really good. This band is pumping out albums regularly, so no gaps from 16 years. This is Necrophobic, sorry, Dawn of the Damned, the newest album. And guys, this is absolutely year material. Fantastic. Blackened death metal, really, really good riff, really good guitar work. The melodies are fantastic. There are some catchy hooks in here, and the vocals completed overall. And really, really, really good stuff. And I love the artwork, looks amazing. This one was released by Century Media, so it isn't hard to get this one. Fantastic band. I really love this band for years. I have multiple albums from this. I'm really glad I could add also this one to the collection. Great band. it can go wrong, and it definitely yearless material. Necrophobic with Dawn of the Damned. Great release. Over to some melodic death. This is a band I have, with this album, I finally have the collection, the discography complete in some formats, some have on CD, some on vinyl, some both. This one I bought on CD, but I have now all the albums. This is the Black Dahlia Murder with Miasma, their second album released in 2005, it says, but yeah, probably, yeah, don't know exactly. But fantastic band, really great melodic death, really Corey side, vocal wise sometimes, but it all fits really, really well. The nice change between high low and high low vocals are fantastic as always. It's not my favorite album from the band, that's why I bought it last. But yeah, I can certainly enjoy this. The cover is way different than other covers the band has done before as well. I like the cover, but I don't know, it don't really fit with the imaging of this band some way. But it's not a bad cover, but they should use some other cover in my opinion. But nonetheless, its album is pretty good, has some good riffing here and there and good songs. Yeah, but it's probably not the first album I would grab if I put on this band. But now I have this album, and sometimes I will try to pick up to get more familiar with this album. Nonetheless, I really enjoyed it. It's not my favorite album, but it's still decent enough that I want to have this. So glad I have it. Miasma by the Black Dahlia Murder. Next up, another gap filler. Is Dark Tranquillity with Character, and this is their 2005 effort. Yes, that's correct. Century Media release. What can I say? I've talked about this band a lot lately, so I'm not gonna ramble too long about this. But this again, pretty aggressive here and there, melodic where it needs to be, fantastic vocals. I can't say anything bad about it. Fantastic album. Character. Go pick it up. If you like their Dark Tranquillity, you definitely will enjoy this. So no bad thing about this. Great band. Next up, an album that will be in my year list, because it's also a 2020 release. This is the new one from Achilles, Melonoi. Probably butchered that, but I don't fucking care. Great release by Dibble Morty, and that's where I also ordered this one. Fantastic, captivating, evil, dark sounding black metal, great riffing, evil vocals. This is definitely the best album they did so far. Not that the other albums are really bad, they are fantastic as well, but this is the top of the mountain for them at the moment. Like I said, evil, captivating riffs. Really like the dark sound in the guitar work. Amazing stuff. I really highly recommend you guys, if you are not familiar with Achilles, definitely take a look at it. If you are into black metal, great, fantastic. Fantastic band. This is the second full length, I think the third release from this band. Probably is like that. Fantastic stuff. Achilles. Go look it up. Next up, a band from France. This is their newest album as well, and it's really great, straightforward black metal. This is Saint-Marie de Loop with Funeraille de Feu. Second album from this band, follow up to their self-titled, which came out in 2018. Fantastic, straightforward, riffy black metal. Can't go wrong here if you like that kind of stuff. If you know the French scene and you like straightforward stuff, fantastic band. Really, really great atmosphere, great riffing. It all fits in here. I really was attracted by the front cover art as well. Really interesting, kind of medieval touch to that. Fantastic stuff. The band name, Saint Marie de Loup, translates in English to Saint Mary of the Wolves. Really great stuff. This was released by Amor Fati. And that's where I also got this. It's fantastic stuff, guys. Really, really great black metal, and definitely take a look into this if you like some really good stuff here. Saint Marie de Loups with Funeraille de Feu. Great stuff. Next up, an album I was also attracted to. I saw this also on Amafati, and I really adored the artwork. So I went to the bandcamp to give it a listen, and it's really, really good. It's Endlichkeit with Teile 1 bis 8, which is this one. And look at that artwork, fantastic snowy landscape. Amazing band, a really great atmospheric black metal from Czech Republic. Really good stuff. This was actually a compilation with demos from 2012 to 2015 or something, 2014. This was released in 2015, I think, 2016, I don't know, but really great compilation of all the demo work, and the atmosphere on this, if you really remind me on Old Birds and that kind of stuff, really, really fantastic atmospheric black metal. I was really, really into it when I heard it, and I thought, well, I need to grab that, so I put it in the basket next to Saint Marie de Loup, and I thought, order. Lengthy songs, not too much guitarist, just riffs build out through lengthy songs, captivating. Really great atmosphere. Sometimes there's a change to make it more interesting, and sometimes it's a speed burst and then it goes slow again. But it's really a great atmospheric stuff, guys. Definitely give into this if you're in the atmosphere black metal. Endlichkeit. Great band. Next up, an album I was meaning to pick up for a really long time. A band, artist I am really familiar with, if you know Mercy Fate, King Diamond, and you know the love from me for the band, for that vocalist. He's a really fantastic singer. I really like his stories on his albums as well. Some really nice concept albums he did with King Diamond. This album I was familiar with, but not as much as Abigail, for example, or Conspiracy, or you know, but it's a really decent album as well. And it was cheap, and I thought, let's pull the trigger. It's King Diamond with House of God. Again, another fantastic concept album, as he always does. Really great riffing, great music, fantastic band. yeah, I can't say anything really bad again about this. If you like King Diamond, then you will enjoy this. It's really great. It's definitely one of the best albums, although it's a lot overlooked because everyone looks at Abigail, like I said, and the early albums. This was released a bit later, I think around 2000 or something. Don't know exact year, but this is a reissue, so it doesn't tell anything as well. But nonetheless, I really enjoyed it. Fantastic release, King Diamond, House of God. Great stuff. Definitely worth picking up. Over to some black metal again. This was a band I was not familiar with, but I ordered this with the Dawnbreed tapes I showed not so long ago. But I was intrigued by the cover again, and I listened to it and really liked it. This is the band's first album, so it's the first thing they put out, and they put it out this year on Soul Records. This is Cold Earth with Your Misery, My Triumph. Fantastic, riffy, black metal. Can't go wrong here. Great stuff. Like I said, this is a new band. There's not much known about this band as well, so I can't tell you a lot. They're kind of a mystery who them as well. I think they are in other bands as well, but yeah, I can't tell right now. Yeah, fantastic stuff. I really adore the artwork, and yeah, really great debut for this. And I'm looking forward to the future, what this band has for us, and if it's a stayer or not. But yeah, really great stuff. Cold Earth, great German black metal, definitely worth picking up. Then over to some death metal, and the last two are both death metal, so if you are not into that, sorry. This is the new one from Mortar Skuld. This is Suffer for Nothing. Yes, he's still on there. Haven't pulled it off yet. Yeah, fantastic old school death metal, and if you look at that album cover, it screams like that. Old school death metal, and they are from, man, it kind of escapes me a bit. Stupid me. Doesn't matter. But this is a band I know for since the 90s, I think. The first two albums, Dire Remains and Humanity Fades, are fantastic albums. I got to know him by a compilation CD, I think, from it's called Death Metal, D-E-A-F, I think that compilation. I have it somewhere, but I'm not gonna pull it out. Anyways, it was a fantastic song I heard, so yeah, I really tried to follow this band. They quit for a long time. They released four albums, and after that they disappeared for 20 years. And they quit in 1997, and they reformed in 2000. And 2017 was a reissue of a new album. Wounds Deeper Than Time, I think it's called. I have that on vinyl. It's a fantastic album as well. And now finally, after 3 years, they are back with a new album. Fantastic old school death metal. If you like that kind of stuff, yeah, you can't go wrong here. Mortar Skuld, Suffer for Nothing, released by Peaceville. Go look into this. Let me know if you like it, guys. Fantastic band. And the last one, I'm finally glad to own, because everybody was craving about it last year. But every time I wanted to finally pulled the trigger to order this. This was sold out. Finally, there's a new issue of this, and I took my chance this time. This is Vulci with Tropical Sun, their second album, Italian death metal, really deep growls, heavy riffing, horror themed stuff. If you know the name Vulci, then you know what you are into, because Vulci is named after the director, the horror director, Lucio Fulci. It's really, really, really great horror films. Great Italian director. But Fulci is named after this, and the music is also based on his movies. This one in particular is based on the film Zombie 2, which is a really fantastic horror movie. Tropical Sun is this album called, and this is of the Sun edition because of the yellow case. This is a pretty nice edition. Really, really Fallout. I really like the artwork as well. Fantastic, fantastic stuff. Yeah, really great death metal. Yeah, a lot of people already know this. If you are into death metal, then you already heard this for a long time. But if not, guys, definitely worth checking out. Always good to check out some really great bands. Fantastic death metal, Vulci with Tropical Sun. So, that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this update. I hope you had a great Christmas time. And yeah, looking forward to share you my year list. I'm still working on it. It will appear sometime soon, so don't worry. I'm not getting rid of me yet, because I have some more stuff to show in 2021. Probably will be vinyl in CDs. There's a lot of stuff waiting to let you show. Anyways, hope you enjoyed it. I will leave links in the description so you can check everything out. Let me know what you think of the releases. Did you like it? Didn't you like it? If you want to share something else cool from this year, or share your experiences or whatever, you're always allowed to put it in the comment section. Hope you enjoyed, like I said, a great Christmas, and hopefully yeah, you have some fun at the end of the year. Hope to get a better year than this year, not only music wise but definitely in normal life than this lockdown shit. Anyways, cheers, and hope you all stay healthy, and see you guys next time. Cheers.